Hello friends, imagine you're going to a fun fair with your school friend and your dad gives you 200 bucks to spend. There will be a possibility of either of the two options. One, you may spend your money randomly, like you may spend on some rides near entry point or whichever will come in your way that are not so fun. Then you realize that there are still good rides left. Also, tempting food items available. But at that moment, you will be out of money. Or the second option is, when you arrive at the venue, you will first look at all rides, food items available, bus fare for coming and going back home, and accordingly, you will spend your money to the optimum level. Now, which one would you choose? Second one, right? This is called planning. Once money is spent, it's gone. The same thing with time. It's more precious than money. And for students, time during exam preparation period is even more precious. So be careful, do plan before you spend your time. It may happen that you spend more time on a couple of subjects at the beginning and then fall short of time for the remaining subjects. So planning is very important, especially when you're appearing for your annual examinations. So today, we will suggest you some study planning techniques which will help you to study all the subjects on time. Let's start preparing reading timetable before annual examinations. Let us assume you have 30 days to go before examinations and there are 6 subjects. So friends, the first and foremost step is to calculate the time and divide it accordingly. First, we will keep contingency for 3 days. This is for sickness or there is some important festival or family function. Then we will keep 3 days for revision. Now we have 24 days balance. You can spend total 10 hours for reading the content of specific subjects. So that means you have got 240 hours. That means you can spend 4 days per subject or 40 hours per subject. This is just an average format. Some subjects may need more time and some subjects could be prepared in a lesser time. It also depends on each student. For example, if you're good at math, then you can keep 3 days for math, and if you're weak at science, you can give a day extra for it, and so on. But remember, the total must be 24 days and sticking to it is also very important. This exercise is for all the subjects. Now let's do the time segregation for each subject. First, let's talk about the mathematics. You can divide the time depending upon your conviction on the chapter. If you're weak at real numbers and that carries 5 marks weightage, then you can keep that topic for option or you can give less amount of time to that topic. So this way, you can divide time to each topic depending upon your strength and weaknesses and weightage of the topic. And also, weightage of the topic should be taken into consideration. Make sure that you have also kept time for paper solving and group study. This will really help you to score well. You can do this exercise for all the subjects. We have subject-wise tips which are available on our YouTube channel. So please have a look at them. Make sure that you have gone through all these topics and subjects. Now, while dividing your day schedule, try to learn theory topic in morning and practical in the afternoon. Please note all time, hours, days are indicative in nature. Each student must prepare plan as per his or her strength and weaknesses. Please do not copy others' plan. Here are some important tips. Please try to solve question papers at home as if you're sitting for examination. Try to do revision for topics which you find difficult. Group discussion. This is a very important thing to do with your friends. This will enhance your concept knowledge. Also, you won't forget it. No need to mug up things. Try to learn logically, which will help you to understand it for your life. Teaching friends. You may teach some topics to your friends which you are good at. This will not only help your friends but also help you to strengthen your knowledge. Please collect or collate all study materials before you start your reading schedule. You should not be searching for something last minute. Have a confidence about whatever you have read or prepared is there in your mind. Keep a habit of writing important points or try to make your own notes. This will help you to strengthen subject knowledge. One last tip for students who are weak at some subjects. You are only weak at some subjects or topics, but you may be strong in other topics or subjects. Please do not worry. Try to plan subject-wise and topic-wise whatever suits you. You may completely omit or leave some topics or chapters which you find it very difficult. Some topics can skip in option questions. Check marks weightage for the same. Remove it from total and try to get passing marks from the other topics. Concentrate on topics which you find easy. Try to get full marks from those topics. Hope this was helpful to you. Please pray to God regularly. Try to spend some time on meditation. It will definitely help you in many ways. So if you have enjoyed this session, please hit the like button. You can also comment your queries in the comment box given below. Till then, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.